So this is another one of my series around obesity and what's causing obesity and how really government inaction, how company inaction, commercial inaction is leading to a significant obesity crisis that is costing individuals enormously at an individual level, but also from a society level, it's just profound. And the question in my head constantly comes up, and the frustration is, why? Why can't we make decisions? Why can't we understand it? And I've come to realize that fundamentally, when it comes to weight, it's a multifactorial illness and disease. And so it's very difficult to find simple things to do to make a very big difference. And it also leads to people becoming very angry and irate about certain kinds of diet, whether that's a high-carb diet or a low-carb diet or a high-fat diet. The latest trends around ketogenic diet. All of these diets kind of ignore the fact that ultimately what we're dealing with is, you know, calories. And so if a person consumes more calories than they need, simply put, we put on weight. And so if we're going to really look towards a society-wide change in helping a lot of people lose weight, we need to reduce the thing that's causing weight gain, which is calories. And I've come to realize the single most important thing actually is not based on nutrition or what kind of diet you're eating or whether you're exercising or not. It's actually something much more fundamental, and it's based not so much in nutrition and medicine, but in physics and mathematics and geometry. And I want to give you this as an example. So this is a cube. And for a second, I want you just to pretend that it's one by one by one. Now, if that's the case, the volume is one. And if we follow the laws of physics, the mass is also one. But what happens if I'm going to double the cube? Well, then I need to double it in each direction. And so it becomes not so much one by one by one, but two by two by two. So that means that the volume then is two times two times two, which is eight, and the mass is eight. So going from a single cube of one to one that's twice the size increases the mass by eight times. And if that's a food product, it increases the number of calories by eight times. So let's say, as an individual, we all live in this world and we go and buy an apple. Now, from our perspective, we're just buying an apple. But if a decision was made because of economic reasons that the farmer is going to produce an apple that is 30% bigger. Well, 30% bigger means that that's 30% times 8. So the apple isn't an apple, it's 2.4 times the apple, or 2.5 apples. Now, unless we understand this and start to put in place strategies around helping people reduce the amount they're eating, and fundamentally, that is around portion size control. Mandated portion size control is going to be the only way that we can help people lose weight in this society. I was in Japan recently, and it was no surprise that in a country with 3% obesity rates, 3%, as compared to most of the rest of the world at 30%, the Japanese Kentucky Fried Chicken was a third of the Kentucky Fried Chicken you'd see in America or Australia, one third the size. So we're going to have to make some changes, and we're going to have to do it in a very simple way. In the next video, I'm going to show how something as straightforward as a pizza, by just making small changes to something as straightforward as pizza, can lead to a drastic reduction in calories without actually asking people not to eat pizza anymore. So look out for that video and watch this space, because unless this concept is broadly accepted across society, this is only going to get worse and going to cost us all a lot more money. And governments need to listen. And the people that make decisions need to hear this. So if you can, please share this video.